Hey everybody, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS and JANGBRiCKS.com with a summer 2013 Mega Bloks Halo set. This is from the new REAP-X, REAP-X, Reverse Engineering and Prototyping Xenotechnology Department series that they've come out with. This is set number 97116, a UNSC siege bike. And if you're not familiar with this part of the Mega Bloks line, the REAP-X line, the ones that have this logo on the box. Basically, what it boils down to is these are non-canon items. So they've just kind of developed for themselves with the blessing of I believe 343 Studios and Microsoft. They've just gone off and created a way for them to create new stuff that doesn't actually exist in the game. So they're actually adding to the Halo universe, and even things that aren't in the books or any other parts of the expanded universe of Halo. So this is not something you'll be able to play anywhere in any game yet, but it's intended to be in this universe. So first off, we'll take a look at the figures, and we start off with a UNSC Spartan in CIO armor. And unfortunately, mine didn't quite get the best quality of paint for the visor, for the kind of three eyes, a little spillage across the side there. If you have not seen this armor before, check it out. I like the torso on this one. So I don't like the face, especially with this particular paint scheme. There's no black in there. If they had filled in the face with a matte black first and then come back with the detail for the gold for the visor bits, I think that would have looked much better. But as it is, it's just so shiny. I don't like this color scheme. I hope that there will be more color schemes for this guy. But I definitely like that torso. I like that torso a lot. That's looking really good. The legs are pretty interesting too. A little on the rectangular side, you know, a little blocky, boxy, but that's interesting to me. I like that. Looks, again, the torso looks really good from the back. Good detail on this. I really think that with a better paint scheme, this could become a very nice looking and fairly well respected figure. You saw that what he had been carrying was just a plain black assault rifle, you know, just your standard issue stuff. Here's the other figure. You're not supposed to be able to see him because he's got active camo. It's a grunt, Storm Grunt with active camo. Here's my question. Do we really need grunts with active camo? I'm gonna answer my own question. The answer is no. You know, imagine you get completely surprised by one of these guys and he pops out and starts attacking you. You know, you twitch over, headshot, grunt birthday party, he's dead. They're not gonna make this an easy to attain figure. It's probably in clear form. It's probably gonna be exclusive to this set. And I just think it doesn't make sense. Comes with a needler though. The needler is cool. You can use that with some other stuff. It's clear, so that's you know, it's a little more difficult to fit with stuff, but I appreciate that, and it looks good. Basically, this guy looks like an ice sculpture. So, you know, just have it for a celebration or something. Anyway, one more thing that's included with the set before we get to the main thing that the set's really about. It's a Forerunner beacon. Only uses a handful of parts, so you're really not paying much for this, you know, in terms of the price of the set. And it's small and it's basic and it's obviously Forerunner, and it looks pretty good. I like it. Simple, cheap, and you know, it's just a thing. Now, this is a siege bike set review, so here's a siege bike now. It's a nice looking bike. It kind of reminds me of the tanks in the old original G.I. Joe series. It's a pretty cool looking thing. This is a kickstand right here. It helps it to stand up. Has the has a big, nice cannon on one side, a couple of sighting sort of things or targeting related elements added onto it. Got a little flexible, well, semi-flexible antenna back on the back. You can see it does hold the Spartan in place. He's able to actually hold on to the handlebars there. kind of do whatever you want with the legs back here. And on this side, nothing going on there. So it's asymmetrical. Doesn't really look balanced in that sense with all that weight over on that side and nothing else on this side. They could have added something more to give us more bulk, more something on this side just to kind of balance it out. But I think it still looks pretty cool. You do have a kind of a, you know, you've got the kickstand on this side, which you can go up and down with. On this side, you've got the exhaust. And look at that. It's got a tail light. How very proper and legal. The tread on this thing, well, it does move, kind of, but you really have to force it. And it will get stuck. Come on. There you go. There's that stuck point again. There we go. It's not really working very well. If you have a hard surface that you're going to be playing on, then you can kind of do the tread motion. Otherwise, you're just going to hold it and just kind of slide it across the surface, because that's what's normally going to happen with this thing. Tread doesn't work very well. I do like this piece in this color. Only thing that three things I don't like about this. One, the tread doesn't really move that well. Two, the balance is a little bit off. Three, the guy, whatever Spartan you put in there, he's not going to be able to look up very well. This one especially, he's looking down in the little console there, basically. No sticker there for detail. By the way, that's not a sticker. And no other stickers on this thing, or no other markings, but that's actually printed onto the piece. But on the box, they actually show him in this pose right there, where he's looking forward. That looks good. That is proper. But this is just a little bit off. But still, for what it is, it's cool. It's different, non-canon, but blessed nonetheless by the makers of Halo for now. And you know, it's a cool little additional thing. The active camo grunt, really, I think that's pretty silly. You can get active camo grunts from the Cobalt Covenant battle set, but they're not the same kind. They're just the regular most expendable type of grunts. But I think that's just a silly concept in general. But still, an interesting set. Do I think that it is worth $12? I think that's a little bit of a stretch. I think they might be trying to pull you in with a higher price point because of the exclusive minifigs here. I don't think that if they had just given you a regular grunt and maybe a repaint of a different armor type, I think they probably would have had the price down at like $9.99 instead of $11.99. But I think you can do better for that price. But if you like the look of this thing, then do go for it. It's a simple and easy build. It's definitely something that would look good if you had a number of them and put different Spartans in different ones. This thing, like I said, it's just a thing. You know, it just basically gives you a little bit of terrain texture, or just gives you some extra parts to make custom stuff yourself. So value, design, interesting. Looking forward to more of these non-canon things, see what they can come up with. So that's it for this video. That's all I have to say about this. Please feel free to let me know your thoughts in the comments field. And, you know, let the rest of the viewing community see what you think. And let's just see what thoughts are in general. Other than that, stay tuned for more reviews to come. And look for all of my updates at JANGBRiCKS.com. Bye for now.